We've spent a lot of time studying the surface of Mars, so we know that there's not macroscopic life like trees or dinosaurs, but there could still be microscopic life there today. And so when we're looking for, you know, different environments in which life might persist today, rock varnish is actually a really strong candidate.
The microorganisms are found all over the planet, but what a lot of people don't recognize is they also habitate places that look inhospitable, such as the surface of buildings or the surface of the smooth rock. And that's where they might be involved with varnish formation.
Here at Los Alamos, we're building a new instrument to explore the surface of Mars on the Mars 2020 rover. And this instrument is called SuperCam, and it's gonna be an amazing tool for us to explore these questions about, you know, where can life exist on Mars? It's actually a really great way to study varnishes. So rock varnish is forming in these really, really unfriendly environments to life. You know, these are arids, it's really dry. Often there's extremes in temperatures, very hot, very cold. And sometimes the radiation environment isn't that great in these desert environments. So these are not places where life, you know, can easily exist, but...
What we're finding with rock varnish is the organisms that populate these surfaces are organisms that are very good at surviving under low water conditions, high irradiation.
And so one of the big constituents of rock varnish is the element manganese. And there's quite a bit of it in there. So a really exciting result we just had from Mars is that we found very high concentrations of manganese on Mars. We don't know if it's part of varnish, but that opens up a lot of possibilities. One of the things that we're doing now in preparation for sending SuperCam to Mars is examining rock varnish from Earth in the laboratory so that we can understand its signatures before we get to Mars. If some of the manganese that we've seen on Mars is actually part of rock varnish, this might be a clue to us that we should look there for signs of life.